Oh, hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial video. And today I'm teaching how you can set up on-page SEO for your Shopify store. So I keep focusing on SEO because if your on-page SEO is not good enough, no matter how hard you work on your off-page SEO, it's not gonna show up well on Google. Also, if you are creating a shop website or any other sort of website, you must know how to set up on-page SEO on that platform, because if your website is not showing up in Google properly, or if it's not ranking for your keyword, then trust me, your website's not gonna work and you won't be getting any more sale. You'll be just throwing money on the trash. So let's jump into this tutorial while I teach you how you can set up on-page SEO for your Shopify store. So guys, this is a Shopify store which we built for one of our clients. It's a recently launched Shopify store, and it's also not submitted to Search Console and not showing up to Google. So how do we check that first? So I'm gonna add site double dot before the URL, and when I hit enter, as you can see, this URL is not being indexed by Google. Now, our first step is, before submitting to Google, first step is to fix the on-page SEO so Google index the website with the proper keywords. Now, this client is selling pregnancy pillows, as you can see. The first step is to add meta title and meta description for homepage in Shopify. And in order to do that, we'll go to the backend. And from your dashboard, click on online store and then preferences. So let me show you guys on Google what actual is meta title and meta description. Now, if we go on Google and search for any keyword, in my case, I'm searching for WebSense Pro Optimize Your Online Store. In return, we are getting results from Google which are related to this keyword. And on top of that, we have meta title. Below that, we have meta description. So we added a keyword, and in return, Google chooses the appropriate results which are matching to this keyword. So we should be focusing on adding more keywords on our meta title and meta description, which we are doing in our Shopify store right now by going into preferences and updating the meta title and meta description. So in this case, we can use 65 to 70 characters. We already have keyword on the title, but we still have some space left, which we will consume to make sure we are adding more keywords on our meta title. Now let's add some more keywords in the meta title to consume all the 65 to 70 characters limit. So guys, I have updated meta title and meta description using the website content, and as you can see, I have tried to use the keyword, which is this, more often in our meta title, in meta description, to make sure our website shows up when someone search for pregnancy pillows. Now let's hit save and make sure it's showing up on our tab here. So as you can see, our meta title has been updated. So when you hover over your tab, you should be able to see the meta title. And you can confirm your meta description by going to view source, view page source, and check out the meta name description. So that's our meta description, which will be shown on Google once someone see this website on Google search results. And this is same as what we added here. Make sure to do all the on-page SEO before submitting your website to Google, because once your website has been indexed, Google might take more time to re-index the website, and your website might lose SEO juice. Cool. So we are done with our first step, which was meta title and meta description. Now let's check out the second step, which is the social sharing image. So what is social sharing image? So when you share your website through Facebook, through Google, Twitter, or any other social media platform, you will see a small a thumbnail, a meta title, and meta description. It's not meta title, meta description, but it's title and description, which shows up on social media platforms. Now I'll update this section and share this URL on Facebook to make sure we have this section also covered up. So guys, first we'll click on social media image preview change image, and let's take up a nice looking image. We can use this one. Actually, this one is much better. So I'm saving this on my desktop and updating that in Shopify social media section. Okay, now when we have our image updated, let's hit save. Now, as you can see, the page title has been picked same as this one, and the description is picked same as this one. Now, in order to test how it looks on Facebook, we will go to Facebook Debugger tool. This is our Facebook Debugger tool. So if your website preview is not showing up in Facebook, make sure to go to this tool and try to debug it. Try to debug your URL. So Google will scrap that URL and shows up the image and description on the social media. So click debug. And as you can see, Facebook is telling us that this URL hasn't been shared before, so please fetch new information. This will always happen whenever you will add a new blog post or launch a new website which is not being shared before. You should be doing this with the Facebook Debugger tool. Now click on fetch new information. And here we have our title, our URL, and our image showing up, which we set up on our social preview section. And now when we will share this URL on our Facebook or anyone's Facebook profile, it will display like this. So that's the section which will be displayed on Facebook when someone shares this URL after debugging it. Okay guys, this is it for the part one of this tutorial. I'll create part two of this tutorial, in which I'll show how to submit your website to Google Search Console, submit your Shopify store to Google Search Console, and fix on-page SEO on your product pages. So if you want to learn more about Shopify, comment on the video below, subscribe to my channel, like and share.